So a few days ago, I sat down with the full intention of researching the 10 best funk bass lines of all time. You know, to make a cool video for you guys. But after I really dug into it, I realized that it'd be actually way more interesting to make a video focused on amazing bass lines that you might not have heard. So in this video, we're gonna be checking out the 10 greatest funk bass lines that you have probably never heard. Hey, it's Scott Devine here from scottsbasslessons.com, helping you to take your bass playing to the next level. And on this channel, we focus on one thing and one thing only.
Bass.
We do YouTube tutorials, we talk about gear, we create video essays about the favorite bass players that you might have and everything in between. So if you are new here, new to this channel, make sure that you hit that subscribe button below the video. So first up, we've got Narada Michael Walden and the track I Should Have Loved You. Which was recorded in 1979, and unfortunately, I don't know who the bass player is. So if you do know who the bass player is on this track, link it up below, let us know in the comments. And this is just one of those bass lines every bass player needs to know. Hear the ghost notes? So what I'm going to do now is slow that down so you can just hear it and get it under your fingers. 1, 2, 3, 4. So next up, we've got Fat Larry's band, Act Like You Know, which was recorded in 1982, and the bass player might have been Larry LaBesse. I'm not 100% sure. If you are 100% sure, let us know in the comments. Now, let's check it out. And he's playing with a pick as well. I think he's got like an old, I'm not sure what that bass is. If you know what that bass is, let us know. Yeah. So let me just slow that down for you a little bit. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now next we've got Tom Brown, and the track is called Funkin' for Jamaica, recorded in 1980, and the bass player was, again, unknown. If you know who the bass player is, let me know in the comments. And this one, we've got the octave pedal on. How killer is that? So the more nerdier bass players of you, like me, might know this next one, but for you that don't, it's Don Blackman, Heart's Desire, recorded in 1982 with Barry Johnson on bass. This is just one of those must-know bass tunes. Check this out. Really unique tone as well. It's like out of phase or something. Thank you. Check these out. So this next track is again another absolute killer for bass players. It's just one of those must-know tunes, and it's called Glide by the band Pleasure. It was recorded in 1979. The bass player was Nathaniel Phillips, but today we've got good old Definity Rocks on bass. I was nerding out on this bass line, found her playing it, and we featured a few videos ago on the 10 greatest female bass players, so I thought I'd show you her doing her stuff again. So check out Definity doing her thing. Now this next track is called I Need Your Lovin'. It was recorded in 1981. Unfortunately, I don't know who the bass player was, but the artist was obviously Tina Marie. This is just such a cracking bass line. Check it out. Okay, so next up we've got Bernard Wright with Habergabler-Tribbin? Habergabler-Tribbin? I'm not sure how you pronounce it. It was in 1981, and I think the bass player was Marcus Miller. So let's check it out. So next up we've got Mary Jane Girls. The track is All Night Long, recorded in 1983, and the bass player is Oscar Alston. Here we go. Check out the snare. More reverb.
Hey boy, would you meet me on the roof tonight? I got a surprise for you.
Next up we've got Vernon Birch, and the track is called Fun City, recorded in 1980, and the bass player is unknown. So let's take a listen and then I'll break it down for you. So the last track is by Curtis Hairston. The track is Chilling Out, recorded in 1986. The bass player, again, unfortunately unknown. If you could let me know in the comments, that would be amazing. And just check out the tone on this. Sounds mint. Check it. Oh. Can you hear it? That's why I'm working on my up thumbing. Can't go wrong with the DX7, can you? Give me a hey-ho in the comments if you can remember the old DX7. Now, if you enjoyed the content in this video, make sure that you smash that like button underneath the video. And also, before you go anyway, I've also got two more cool things for you, and both are free. Way free! First up is my completely free bass players toolkit that you can grab via the description below. It includes loads of free resources like my video guide to dialing in the perfect bass tone, how to set up your own bass, how to finally understand the modes, those things that are so elusive and we all kind of get, you know, frustrated about. I'll show you how to do that in the Bass Players Toolkit, and you can get it via the link below. And secondly, if you've not checked out scottsbasslessons.com yet, you can grab a totally free 14-day free trial. It is the ultimate learning platform for bass players just like you. scottsbasslessons.com has the largest and coolest course library on the planet, and it's essentially your chance to study with the best bass players and educators in the world from the comfort of your own home and help them learn, or help you learn, this amazing instrument, the bass. Now, both the things that I've just mentioned, the links are below, so grab them there if you want them. And with that said, take it easy, and I'll see you in the shed.